Thank you. Simple Gifts is a Shaker song written back in 1848. It was largely unknown outside of the Shaker communities until Aaron Copland used the melody for the score of his ballet, Appalachian Spring. I think you'll recognize this once you hear it. 'Tis a gift to be simple, 'tis a gift to be free. This arrangement by James Ployer has some significance for me. It was the first piece I ever directed with a school band in the spring of 1975 following my college graduation. So I directed it again a few years later as a band director in Cambridge, and here we are again, Simple Gifts.
Thank you.
Henry Fillmore was a prolific composer of marches, and we played a march written by him last time entitled Courage. Tonight, we're playing another march by Henry Fillmore. The Crosley March was named for Paul Crosley, who was a Cincinnati industrialist who persuaded Fillmore to form a professional band that became very popular on the radio in the late 1920s. I think, as an aside, I think one of the reasons Crosley wanted a popular radio show is he made radios and sold them, Crosley Radio. But so here it is. This is the Crosley March. Thank you. We're going to play a song now. It was composed by Freddie Mercury for the band Queen. It was written for their 1975 album, A Night at the Opera. And though critical reaction was initially mixed, Bohemian Rhapsody became Queen's most popular song and is considered one of the greatest rock songs of all time. In December 2018, it became the most streamed song from the 20th century, and it's been downloaded or streamed over 1.6 billion times. Here comes 1.6 billion and one, our version, Bohemian Rhapsody.
Thank you.
We've got quite a varying number of tunes here, different styles. This one is a song written by Al Dubin and Harry Warren, introduced in 1933 musical 42nd Street, when it was sung and danced by Ruby Keeler and Clarence Nordstrom. The lyrics talk about going by railroad train to Niagara in a sleeper for a honeymoon that's cheaper to Niagara Falls. And this is, it was a popular destination for honeymoon. The song appeared again in 42nd Street when it was a Broadway musical. And here's our own version of Shuffle Off to Buffalo. Well, this is our audience participation one. Don't panic and run for the door. This one is a lot less burdensome than some of them we've done. We used to play a lot of polkas. Almost every week we'd play polkas, and maybe a couple, and we just don't seem to do it as much anymore. But this one was made popular by the Andrews Sisters, and there is a spot for audience participation. It's the Pennsylvania Polka. I'll show you what the participation is. Just. It's just like this. You just have to do it at the right spot, but then you'll see it. I'll help you. Thank you.
like what I ate for dinner is coming up. Eric, here we go.
You guys held up your part admirably, so thank you.
All right.
When I said we have kind of go from one extreme to another tonight, we kind of do. The movie Saving Private Ryan showed very graphically the challenges our fathers or grandfathers faced during World War II, and specifically at D-Day, the invasion. The movie's very well done, but I will admit it was probably not my best moment of fatherly wisdom when I took my then eighth grade daughter to see it. It was pretty graphic, but she's forgiven me, I think. The music for the movie was composed by John Williams, who's composed many memorable scores. The piece we're going to play tonight, Hymn to the Fallen, served as a memorial to those who have fallen in combat. Movie director Steven Spielberg chose to place Hymn to the Fallen on the closing credits in addition to the spot as background music within the movie because what he said, quote, "It will stand the test of time and honor forever the fallen of this war and possibly all wars." He felt it showed Williams's sensitivity and brilliance. And here it is, the Hymn to the Fallen. The next piece we're going to play has a strong connection to the Boston Pops. The composer of the last piece, John Williams, served as the conductor of the Boston Pops for about 15 years, and he still guest conducts today. Prior to that, Arthur Fiedler was the conductor for almost 50 years. During those years, some of the orchestra's most memorable music was creative, descriptive pieces that were composed by Leroy Anderson, and he borrowed sounds from everyday life, like the typewriter was a piece that, where there was a manual typewriter used to have the sound effect. Everybody's heard the familiar sleigh ride at Christmas, and that ends with the horse whinny. And this one you'll probably have all heard as well. Tonight we're going to be tick-tocking with, and nothing to do with that Chinese app, but we're going to be playing the syncopated clock. We're going to continue with another march, or actually a gallop. This another very famous march composer, Carl King, who ran away to the circus as a teenager and spent the next 30, 40, 50 years composing, playing the baritone, and conducting circus bands. Last week, or 2 weeks ago, we played The Trombone King, a piece he wrote. Tonight, we're going to be playing a gallop. If you can imagine being at the circus when the bareback riders would come in through the entrance and gallop around standing on the horses, et cetera. This would be the kind of music that would be used there. This Gallup Circus Days is what you would expect to hear if you went to the circus. They still had it. And so here we go. We're almost galloped out of here, but not quite yet. We've got a couple more.
Once again, we wanted to thank you for coming this evening, for supporting us for these two concerts. It's been a lot of fun for us. Thank you to you. Thank you for the Main Street program. I've acknowledged the musicians many times and really do appreciate their willingness to perform for you, the community, and we have really enjoyed it. But one person I have overlooked is our director. I think when I've said the band in the past, I meant to include him. However, one thing I do want you to all keep in mind is that when he told us when he graduated from college and began directing for the first time, he's a child prodigy, so don't try to figure out how old he is. So anyway, but thank you for coming. And we just have a few pieces remaining, and we hope to see you next summer, hopefully with more concerts.
It's okay if you want to guess how old I am. I reach an age where I forget, so it doesn't really matter. Yeah, okay. That's carrying it a little, All right, we're going to close this concert tonight and the season with a piece titled Highland Echoes, written by Wisconsinite Larry Dane. It's based on 18th century Scottish songs. Those include Blithe Blithe and Mary Was She. I'm sure that was on the hit parade back in 1747. Highland Dance, The Lass of Goree, Scotland the Brave, and the last piece in this medley will be one you'll recognize and will realize it's particularly appropriate that it be the last song we play for this abbreviated summer season. So here it is, Highland Echoes. Echoes? Yeah, Echoes. See, I, you know, how old I am? I can't even remember what I just read. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you. And one last song, you all know it. Please rise and join us in the singing of our national anthem.